Hello everyone, I'm Ryan with PC Part Picker and welcome back to another build video. Today we're putting together a special machine for the 10th anniversary of Asus Republic of Gamers. Asus has put together a part list for a 4K RGB gaming machine centered around their newly released Rampage 5 Edition 10 motherboard. A big thanks to the manufacturers for providing all of the parts of this build. Check the description below for a link to the full part list. Let's get started! On the Rampage 5 Edition 10 motherboard, open up the latches on either side of the CPU socket. Then lift up the cover. Take the i7-6850K and line up the golden triangle with the triangle around the socket. This indicates pin 1. And gently set your CPU into place. Close the latch. And you're all set. For this build, we're using 16 gigabytes of a Vexor Impact ROG certified memory. When using 4 DIMMs on the motherboard, we use the gray slots according to the motherboard manual. So open up the latches on one side, then we'll take the memory and set it into place. In order to fit our components inside of the Thermaltake Core V71 Power Cover Edition, we've had to do a little bit of deconstructing with the case. As you can see, we've removed the front, side, and top panels. We've also taken off the 200mm fans that were at the front of the top of the case, as well as a 140mm fan that was at the rear. We're replacing those with 140mm RGB ring fans that Thermaltake has kindly provided us. We're also removing the 5¼-inch bay adapter from the top here, as it would interfere with our 360mm radiator. There's also a grommet here in the bottom cable management hole that we've taken out as it would interfere with the backplate on our motherboard. We have 3 different modular hard drive cages that we've removed as we're only using a single hard drive and we'll mount it to the back of the case. We're using the Seasonic Prime 850-watt titanium power supply for this build. CableMods has provided us with their premium cable kit of fully sleeved black and red cables. To ease in installation, we're going to plug in our cables to our power supply before we put it into the case. Start with a 24-pin cable. Our motherboard uses an 8-pin and a 4-pin for the CPU power, so we've got 2 8-pin cables that we need to plug in. We have 1 hard drive, so we need 1 SATA power cable. And finally, we have a daisy-chained 8-pin cable for our GPU. Remove the screws holding the power supply shroud to the case. Unclip the shroud from the back of the case and slide it out. Our case has a fan grill at the bottom with a dust filter. So we'll place the fan on the power supply down to intake cold air and exhaust it out the back. Secure the power supply with the provided power supply screws. We've routed most of our cables through the cable management hole, and now we'll secure the power supply cover back to the case. In addition to our SSD, this build is using a 4TB Western Digital black hard drive. We've removed a drive sled from one of the hard drive cages and we'll mount it at the back of the case. Remove the clips from the side of the sled and set the hard drive into the sled. Secure the tabs back into place. Take the hard drive in the sled, set it on the mounts, and it should snap into place. While we're at the back of the case, connect up the SATA power and SATA data cables.
Before placing the motherboard in the case, remember to install the rear I/O shield. Gently set the motherboard into the case and align it with the standoffs. Secure the motherboard to the standoffs with the provided screws. We routed all of our cables from the back to the front of the case. Now let's plug in the front panel I/O and power cables.
Start with the HD audio cable. Connect the USB 2.0 cable to the header on the motherboard. Connect the hard drive LED to the Q connector. Then the reset switch. Next, we have the power switch and our power LEDs. Plug the Q connector into the motherboard. Plug in the SATA data cable from our hard drive, the USB 3.0 cable, the 24-pin power cable, plug in the 8-pin power cable, and the 4-pin power cable.
Before putting our CPU cooler into the case, we're going to mount our fans to the radiator. The radiator will then be mounted to the top and screwed in from above. Secure the radiator to the top of the case with the short screws. Prep the CPU block by snapping the clips to the CPU retention ring. Push the screws through the holes in the retention bracket until they snap into place. On the bottom of the CPU block, remember to remove the plastic covering. Our thermal paste is already pre-applied. Take our retention ring from earlier and line up the notches. It should lock into place. Then take the plastic ring and push it until it is secure. Take the CPU block and line it up with the holes around the socket, then screw it into place. Plug in the cable from the CPU block to the water pump header on the motherboard. Connect the RGB ring fan to the front of the case. And connect our last fan to the back of the case and exhaust. Each of the ring fans comes with a 3-fan controller. This controller adjusts the speed and the color of the LEDs. All the fans from our radiator are going to this controller, and the rest of the case fans will go to this one. Plug in the cables from the fan controller to the headers on the motherboard. Remove the expansion slot covers for our graphics card and SSD. Open the latch on the X16 slot. Take the Asus Strix GTX 1080 and gently set it into place. There's no latch on the X4 slot, so simply push the SSD into the motherboard. Secure the SSD to the expansion slot. And secure the graphics card as well. Plug in the 8-pin and 6-pin power to the graphics card. Finally, plug in the CableMod's LED cable to the RGB Aura header on the motherboard.
All right, with all of our components now in the build, let's turn on the power supply and press the start button on the motherboard. You can see the system booting up and all of our RGB LED fans turning on, and we should be headed to the BIOS here. And that's the screen we're looking for. All you need to do now is install the operating system. Thanks for joining us for another successful build video. And a big thanks to Asus, Avexer, CableMods, Seasonic, Thermaltake, Toshiba, and Western Digital for providing all of the parts for this build. If you enjoyed the content today or learned anything new, please give us a like and subscribe.